Hi and welcome back to another Tech Minds video. So a couple of days ago, the SDRplay team released a version of SDRuno, which now supports plugins. You'll notice that when you visit the download page on sdrplay.com, you're presented with a choice of two versions. We have the regular stable release version 1.33, and on the right we have version 1.4 candidate, which contains the new plugin feature. Now before installing 1.4 release candidate version 1, SDRplay recommend that you create a backup of your sdruno.ini file. Now to do this, just open up a Windows Explorer page and then enter in the following command: %appdata%/sdrplay and press enter. Now from here you can right mouse click on the SDRuno ini file and then select copy, and then right mouse click in the window and select paste. A copy of the ini file will now be visible. You can rename this file to something like sdrunoback.ini just so you know that it's the original backup. And once this is complete, you're now ready to install 1.4 RC1. Now go ahead and download the installer and run it. Now it may take some time to install the prerequisites, but please don't cancel it, just let it run. Now once it's installed, you should be able to launch SDRuno. Now to access the new plugin features, simply press the new plugins button on the main window top left. You'll be presented with a list of currently installed plugins, which you can then load. Now the first plugin which we'll take a look at is the new DAB and DAB Plus decoder. So select DAB from the plugin list and click on load plugin. Now a new window will appear and it should start to list available DAB stations. Now if you do not see any DAB stations, then you either need to change to a different multiplex using the drop down, or your antenna is not able to receive DAB stations. Now the multiplex in my area is 11A to 11D. You can clearly see on the waterfall in the scope, these signal peaks are close together. Now this is what a DAB transmission looks like when received with SDRuno. You don't have to worry about changing the frequency because the DAB plugin does this for you. Now it's more than likely that you do not have the Core AAC decoder installed. If you do, then great, you can just go ahead and select the station and listen to it. Now if not, then a message will appear on the screen with a clickable link which will take you to the Core AAC codec download page. Simply download the codec and install it. Now once installed, you can then restart the DAB plugin. And once a station is listed, you can click on it and start listening.
The 5 minutes segment there.
I know what you would do.
I could give you the full system. Now, we're supporting the government. We want them to get this right in the national.
Bill James was actually let down in that moment by getting put out there in that way. But Rangers have had good backing over the last couple of years. They've signed and they've spent money on players that probably I don't.
Matcham like Dean Jones and Boone, they stayed in the real heartbeat of the side, and Border and Marshy, and they brought in other players.
Now another plugin that got installed is a new version of the audio recorder. Now not only does this record in standard WAV file format, you can now select MP3 as well. Now this plugin is quite self-explanatory. Simply press the folder button to choose where you want the recordings to be stored, and then hit the record button. To stop recording, press the stop button. Now to confirm, this is an audio recorder and will only record the audio that you're listening to. If you want to record the IQ stream as you have done before, then just continue to use the standard built-in recorder. Well, there we go, guys. That's just a brief overview of this new plugin feature for SDRuno. Now, I think this is a really cool feature. I think this is going to open up what is already a fantastic SDR software to something that's going to be quite remarkable, because having the ability to have third-party developers create plugins for SDRuno is going to be a kind of a game changer. We're going to be able to see things that you could not normally do with SDRuno without the addition of some other software. Hopefully, when developers start jumping on board with this and learning how to create plugins, we're going to see some really cool things. I've got my list of plugins that I would love to see happen in SDRuno, but let's just wait and see if they materialize. Anyway, guys, I hope you enjoyed the video. I just want to say a massive thank you to my patrons. And also, if you haven't subscribed, please go ahead and subscribe to see more content like this. Until the next video, guys, take care, stay safe, and I'll see you in the next one.